Today is December 13th, 2015. It is the third Sunday of Advent. This is St. John's Lutheran Church in Springfield, Ohio. We're located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue. Today our service will be a little different than usual. We're having the cantata. We won't have a sermon. So please sit back and enjoy the service.
Thank you. Please turn to page 213 in the front of your worship. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Gus and Connie Singleton will be lighting the Advent wreath.
Thank you. altered forever. This was the moment when condemnation would meet redemption, when the free reign of darkness would meet the light of the world. The time is now, and as the curtains roll back from the divinely set stage, all of creation rose.
Thank you.
400 years, God was silent. From the final words of the prophet Malachi until the proclamation of John the Baptist, from the time between the Old Testament and the New Testament, there was no prophecy, no revelation, no direct communication with his children. What kind of God would leave his people in silence for 400 years?
A God who keeps his promises. A God whose attention to detail would not allow the plan of redemption to unfold prematurely. You see, God is often silent while he is working. During those 400 silent years, God was resetting the world stage. Key prophecies were being fulfilled. The nations of the world were repositioning themselves to be in direct alignment with the scripture. For the first time in history, the Hebrew prophecies were being translated into another language, the universal Greek language, allowing for all nations to recognize the Messiah just at the right time. There was a plan. Galatians 4:4 says, "In the fullness of time, God sent forth his Son to be born of a woman."
But while the curtain was closed, and while God was silent, his oppressed children were crying to him.
Thank you.
Though this sleeping Adonai, the silence of Christmas was beautifully broken. A new song had been born. The Word became flesh and came to live among the very people he had created. A symphony of sound began that night that still echoes throughout the world today. From the cries of the tiny infant king to the multitude of heaven's citizens shouting his praises from the night sky. The time for silence was past, and the time for rejoicing had come.
Perfect. He didn't come to save the righteous, for there unto people crippled by life, unto those who have lost hope, unto the ones who see themselves as damaged,
unto those who work hard, yet still struggle to make ends meet, unto the people who fail the same test again and again, unto those who hurt,
unto those who are paralyzed by their past. Whether we realize it or not, none of us are without the need of a Savior.
We are the broken ones, and so unto us a child is born.
Unto us a son is given.
Child is born unto us, he's come.
delivers us today the same way he has delivered his people since Bethlehem. He gives us his own righteousness.
How can we respond to such an amazing, undeserved gift? We cannot be silent, for if we remain silent, even the rocks will cry out praise in our place. And so we join the great psalmist in exclaiming, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquities? Who heals all your diseases? Who redeems your life from destruction? Who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies? Who satisfies your mouth with good things?
Let the hills
redemption. Let us pray for the church, the world, and all people according to their needs. Our response today to the phrase, God of hopefulness, is hear our prayer. For the whole Christian church, that we might bear fruits worthy of repentance, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. For our stewardship of creation, that it may reflect faithful partnership with you and benefit those who will come after us, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. For all who hunger or lack basic necessities of life, that our sharing may encourage them in hope, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. For those who are hospitalized or ill, that their worries might be given over to you, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. For the children of this community, whose hearts are at home in God, that this might be a safe and nurturing place for them, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. With thanksgiving, we remember all our friends and relatives who have died and rest securely in your arms. May your presence bring comfort to those who grieve, God of hopefulness, hear our prayer. God of salvation, hear the prayers we make in the name of Jesus Christ, whose coming is certain, and whose day draws near. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, be passing the place in peace. May the Almighty and Merciful God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless, comfort, strengthen, and keep you now and forever.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
That was our cantata for Christmas. We're glad to have you here at St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio.
Thanks be to God.